In the United States, the 4th of July marks our Independence Day. And in celebration, millions of Americans enjoy watching fireworks and setting off firecrackers. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about how firecrackers can completely destroy your hearing. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Anthem, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, consider hitting the subscribe button. I love firecrackers just as much as the next guy, but after seeing what they can do to your hearing, I take extra precaution in order to protect my ears from the loud explosion of a firecracker. I can't tell you how many patients I've seen that have lost hearing because they went unprotected when setting off firecrackers. I've even seen patients who have completely gone deaf because of an explosion too close to their ear. Not to mention the pain and suffering that you'll go through when you rupture your eardrum if that explosion happens too close to your ear. When we take a look at the noise level that a firecracker creates, it's easy to see how it can create an instantaneous hearing loss. A firecracker ranks even higher than a jet engine, and it's up there with a gunshot. Take a look at someone screaming in your ear. The average person can sustain this level of noise for 1.5 minutes before risking damage to their hearing. But when it comes to a firecracker, this damage is instantaneous. In fact, the damage caused by a firecracker can be so severe that it can cause distorted hearing, hyperacusis, or like I mentioned before, even deafness. Let's talk about distortion. Distortion happens when the inner hair cells of your inner ear are damaged. These hair cells are microscopic and they are actually what take sound and send it up to your brain. Even if you sustain a hearing loss and you amplify it with something like a hearing aid, the inner hair cells are what take that amplified sound and send it to your brain cleanly. If you don't have the inner hair cells, you don't get a clean signal. Hyperacusis is even worse. This is when a normal sound is perceived as being painful to you. And the biggest problem with this is that if you sustain a hearing loss from a firecracker, you need to amplify sound in order for you to understand speech. However, if you amplify sound, it becomes painful for you. So you can see how it's a double-edged sword because you need amplification, but at the same time, you can't tolerate the amplification. Then you have complete deafness. This occurs when every structure inside of the cochlea is killed, and it can easily happen if you have a firecracker go off too close to your ear. There are only a few things that you can do when you damage your hearing so bad that it causes you to go deaf. Number one is that if you only have deafness on one side, you could use a cross transmitter to take sound from that side and send it over to your better ear. However, the other option is actually undergoing surgery to get a cochlear implant so you can bypass that hearing organ that you completely destroyed and stimulate that nerve directly. Hearing loss due to loud noise exposure is no joke, and you should take all forms of noise seriously, especially when you're setting off firecrackers. All it takes is one firecracker to completely destroy your hearing, and it is very easy to prevent. All you have to do is wear hearing protection or, at a bare minimum, stick your fingers in your ears. So this 4th of July, when you're setting off your firecrackers and you're taking out that box of M80s and throwing them up into the air, make sure you do yourself a favor and protect your hearing. Trust me, you'll be glad you did. That's it for this video. Have a happy 4th of July. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you like the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'll see you next time.